And one more information to all the participants in the meantime, kindly just drop in an email to this particular, the email ID, which we'll be sharing on the chat window right now, so that you can receive your copy of certificate of participation for this particular session. Or you can just drop in a number to me on my WhatsApp. I mean, your email address to my WhatsApp. I shall send it. The number is given on the chat window. Madam, would you like to start?
Yeah, I wanted to.
Yes, you can go ahead.
Hello, good evening all. Can you hear me? Hello?
I'm unmuting everyone.
All participants can.
Yes, Vinodini, I can hear.
Yes, ma'am, we can hear you fine.
Yeah, good evening one and all. Today I thought, I'll utilize this COVID lockdown period by sharing some of my ideas on this particular principles of marketing. So I thought it will be better if I just brush up, the concepts which were there. So I'll start with an interactive session. Rather, I would only speak on this. So first of all, when I talk about marketing principles, the basics I'm going to discuss about, not in detail about the management aspect of it. So first thing is, like, when we start talk about marketing, before entering into marketing, we start with an element called need. Can anyone say what is the need? Can anybody? Anyone? Participants can talk about what is the need? No? Okay, I'll start with it.
Yeah? Need is something, deprivation of something.
Yeah, it's a felt deprivation. Suppose today we are all in a lockdown period. We all felt that there has to be, we all felt deprivation. We all felt that there has to be some platform wherein we can really interact with somebody by being in lockdown. So that kind of felt deprivation is a gap arises within a person, an individual. It can be within in an organization or an individual. It's a gap which arises within an individual. Once the gap arises, what is the next aspect is we feel like fulfilling that particular gap, right? That the next level of need is the want. That means when we try to fulfill the need, it moves up to from the need aspect to the want aspect. So when these two are there, then what is the next level which has to be learned is the demand factor. So what is demand? Can anybody try? Two important aspects in a demand comes up. What is that? Only two aspects. Any participant, because this I wanted to make it an interactive session. What is demand? In general.
Just to fulfill the needs, we need something. Like demand can be anything, any product, anything which and it depends on the
person's need or a want.
Want. And it depends on our, financial status also.
So in a nutshell, two important aspects. Purchasing power backed by willingness. Simple. In simple funda, it is need, demand is created by the two important aspects, by fulfillment of purchasing power and willingness. These are the two important aspects where a demand can be generated. Now, I'll move to the next level since we know needs, wants, and demand. The next aspect what I would like to talk about is I'll just get into the marketing. Now, you tell me, we all know, some of us know, who is the customer and who is the consumer. Can anybody? Or you want me to? Who is a customer?
Customer who buys. but may or consumer. May not consume it. Consumer is the person who is the end user and who actually consumes the product or use the product.
Exactly. So the customer can be a consumer, but consumer may or may not be a customer. Am I correct? Customer can be a consumer, but consumer may or may not be a customer. See, if I, for example, customer, as you said just now, customer is a person who makes a purchase or who buys a product. Consumer is a person who uses or consumes a product or a service, right? So suppose my father has bought some plantains for me, right? Some bananas. He has become the customer. And when he gives it to me, I become the consumer who consumes a product. Suppose my father has bought the bananas and he also purchased and consumed, he becomes both customer and a consumer. But me, I may not become the customer. That means customer can be a consumer, but consumer may or may not become a customer. This is one of the aspects before I getting into the basics of marketing. Now, since we learned about what is market, I mean, what is customer and who is a consumer? Now, what do you mean by a product? What do you mean by product in general? I want in a simplified way. I don't want a big definitions. Can anybody try?
Product could be something which satisfies the need of a consumer or
a want. Like if we see from our marketing perspective, it is a product. In a simplified way, is bundle of benefits. For example, if I go to a restaurant and if a food is served to me, do I see, you know, if a biryani is served, whether it is veg or a non-veg, do I look at the color of the rice and the color of the curry and number of items available here? Do I see that physically or do I see it psychologically? I try to see the products. I assume the products in a psychological way, which means product means it is considered as bundle of benefits, wherein we try to see when we pay a particular price to a particular product, we understand that particular product has satisfied our need or a want, and we are happy with the price what we paid for it. So we psychologically look at the product. Today, when we talk about product, when we buy about a product or a service, we don't literally talk in terms of product or service. What we buy as a customer is we buy values and beliefs. We just don't buy a product or a service. We buy our values and beliefs. Papa ne aisa kiya, so I'm going to follow that. Mama ne aisa kara, so I'm going to follow this. So, we have certain value systems at our home, right? So this is what a customer will buy, values and beliefs rather than physical products or services. They try to fulfill the needs or wants, but provided this is a psychological aspect which goes into buying values and beliefs. This is what a product is, which means it indicates as bundle of benefits. Anything that is offered to the market for acquisition, attraction, purchase or resale. This is what to satisfy your need or a want is what a product is. Now, since you have told me what is a product, can you just differentiate between what is a good or a product? Can you? Can anybody try? What's the difference between a good and a product?
So can anybody participate? The participants can unmute themselves and then speak.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah. What is a product and what is a good? Product, I told you just now, it's bundle of benefits. What do you mean by a good?
Ma'am, product means it's like a finished good which is ready to use.
Okay. And what is a good?
Goods means it is like a raw material which is not goods.
This is one particular perspective. It is not from marketing perspective, but I'll try to correct you. Good is a generic name. Good is considered as a generic name of a particular item or an article. Rice, dal, salt, tamarind, pepper, these are all the generic names of a particular item or an article is called as good. Neither it is an unfinished nor a finished. Is it clear now? Am I clear? Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, and when it comes to product, it is a branded name. A name is given. For example, if I talk about a product and a good, good just now I told you, rice. When I talk about basmati rice, it becomes a branded name, not the original generic name of basmati. Right? When I talk about atta or a wheat, and if I that becomes a good. But when I say Captain Cook atta, it's a branded name. So there is a categorization between a generic name and a branded name. That is the difference between a product and a good. Am I clear? Am I clear to the participants?
Yes, ma'am.
Hello? Yeah, yes, you ma'am. Can. All the participants can interact. Otherwise, I feel I'm only talking, you know. Right.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
The next aspect I would like to clear is, then when we talk about product or service, what do you mean by service? What do you mean by product?
Service is intangible, whereas product is tangible.
Product is tangible. Where, you know, for example, I'll give a simple example with regards to these two categorizations. When it comes to product, when I go to a particular dealer to buy a color TV, right? What I do is I try to check the sound, I try to check the picture quality, I try to check the price, and then if I like, I'll try to compare with other products, competitor products, and then I own it. Right? That is in case of a physical product. But similarly, as Dr. Vijayalakshmi just now said, first we consume or use, then we tell our opinion. We tell about satisfaction or dissatisfaction. I'll give an example of this. Like when I go to a saloon or a parlor, that lady will show me different shade, different patterns of hairstyles. Like, so first I'll consume that means she'll make a haircut. Afterwards, I'll get to know whether that pattern has come or not. The same pattern has been performed on my hair or not, that I'm going to see. That means first you use or consume, then you'll try to give the opinion with regards to satisfaction level. But when it comes to product, the situation is first we'll see the product. Once we are satisfied, then only we own. That means it has its tangibility, and when it comes to service, it has its intangibility. Service simultaneously. Hope I'm clear. Am I?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. When I talk about philosophies of marketing,
Vinodini, ma'am.
Yep.
Sorry to interrupt. You have now an access to move the slides from your end. You can actually move the slides even from your end, apart from me.
You can
scroll the slides.
I'm getting it. Yeah.
Yes.
I'm not able to.
Can I go to the next slide?
Kartikeya. Next slide. Third slide. You go to the third slide. No issues. I'll discuss about philosophies of marketing. So five important philosophies have been evolved, which started with production concept, product concept, selling concept, marketing concept, and societal concept. So these are how the concept of marketing has emerged from the seller's point of it to the buyer's point of it. Right. So when it comes to production concept, the sellers used to feel that whatever we produced after the war, in a particular nation, world war, people felt that that was all about industrial point of it. They used to assume that whatever we produce, customer has no choice. They have to buy whatever we produce. They had limited choice. So during that period, the production concept has worked out. Then in the later stages, once the employment has been generated and people had some amount to fulfill their needs and want, they move to the next level of product concept. They were not just happy with whatever has been produced by the producers. They wanted to have something else. That means they wanted more features or attributes in a particular product because they effort, since they have employment, they can afford to buy products or services which have little more features or attributes. So that concept also has worked out. So what the producers have done is they worked out by adding some more features, assuming that if you add more features, customer would definitely buy the product or a service. So that also worked out to some extent. But in the later stages, the producers felt that it is not just adding the features, but we need to say blah blah. We need to talk about the product, since so many competitors have entered in the market. So they decided whoever convinces the about the product or a service, that particular customer is going to buy. So bombarding about your product is what we talk in sales concept, selling concept. Even that worked out very well. Then in the later stages, even suppose if I go to a shop, if that guy says, the sales guy says that, madam, it suits you, this will work out for you, this will help you, this, even if he says so much of blah blah, we are not going to buy the product unless until our pockets are green, unless until I wanted it, I need it. If I don't need it, even if he say anything, if he says that, I'm going to give you freely also, you're not going to buy because you don't have a need for it. So then emerges the concept of marketing. The marketing concept holds that first we need to find the need. Unless until you identify the need of a target customer, you are not going to really fulfill the customer. That means customer is not going to buy. So the three important aspects of marketing emerge. That is, find a need, fill it with satisfaction. So these are the three important. Find a need. See, as we just know in the first slide, I discussed about need, want, demand, right? When I talk about need is a felt deprivation. So as a marketeer, I need to identify their need. What is it that they need? It is not that, I'm going to create a product and I'm going to tell him, come on, you buy the product. It is not that. It is no more that. Customer need has to be identified. Once the need has been identified, we need to create the product. When you create the product, automatically it is matching there, it is fulfilling their need. That means the product which has been created has to satisfy the need or want of a customer. That is a major aspect, the emerging aspect of marketing concept, which is working. Still it is working, it will work. Because the only thing which has been added in the societal concept, that is the fifth philosophy, is societal concept. See, for example, I would like to quote an example with regards to this particular one. Kinetic Honda has launched, vehicle called Kinetic Honda. So the main thing was, what they said is, people were happy with that. Just, button start and it goes on. But it was emitting lot of pollution. So what they did, for a marketeer, he is only interested in customer satisfaction. He is not interested whether it is emitting pollution or not. He wants his sales. See, today we have banned Ambassador, we have banned Kinetic Honda because it emits a lot of pollution. Since the societal concept, what has come into picture is, not only as a marketeer, as an organization, you need to consider customer satisfaction, but you have to also survive within the society. That means it should benefit the society. It should not spoil the society. It should enhance societal interest, rather spoil the societal interest. So the societal concept has come out with global warming, all these scenarios, water pollution, air pollution, noise pollution. So we need to take into consideration societal interest, because other than customers are people, right? Whom you are serving are the customers, but other than customers are the public, are the society. So we need to consider the societal interest, then only your survival will be there. Otherwise, you have to shutter down your shop. That is a basic concept behind societal. We talk in terms of CSR, corporate social responsibility. Not only serving your customers, but we need to enhance the value and standard of living of the society also. Am I clear? Please raise. Am I clear? Am I getting you?
Yes, very well.
Okay.
Yes, okay, ma'am.
Thank you. Then I'll go to the next aspect. When we are talking in terms of philosophies, then let's talk about market. What is market? What is marketing? Can anybody, just even if it is a wrong answer, I'll be very happy at least you raised a voice. Tell me, what is market?
Yeah, market is a place.
Don't say it is a place.
Where exchange of goods.
Don't say it is a place. Other than place. Other than place.
Market is a bulk of different products are available in market.
Available where? Again, where has come, right?
Ma'am, marketing is a process.
Process is also somewhere it goes on, right? Somewhere you are talking in
ma'am,
terms
example,
of
example vegetable where, market, right? Ma'am. In vegetable market we have different
that is a where only, no, it is a place. You are talking about place only, right?
Some commercial dealings are done, market is a place.
Again,
where some commercial dealings are done. Again, I'm coming back to
place only. I said other than the place, let us talk about.
Okay. It's a gathering of people for buying and selling.
Market.
Kahan pe gather ho rahe hai? Where people are gathering? Somewhere, right?
Market can be the,
I'll come back.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Market is the process where the price is being set for the product according to the demand and supply.
Where means what, ma? Where means
ma'am,
what?
Example, Flipkart, ma'am. Flipkart, have you some
market? That's the virtual market.
So physical or non-physical could be, na, ma'am?
Yeah, market is a setup. It is a setup for exchanging of...
Market is a place.
Extension is a place. See, I said other than the place. Anyway, good answer, sir. I'm quite satisfied.
For exchange of
guys are participating. There's an interactive session, right? So now, from marketing point of it, say is not where. We say in terms of the people who buy the product. That means the people who have already purchased the product, the people who are going to buy the product. I did not use the word where. Actual and potential customers of a product is market. I didn't use where. Okay, the one who already use the product, the one who are going to use the product is market. I hope I'm clear.
Yes, like market is a kind of demand wherein it should be, isn't it?
Two people will be there in that one. Those have already consumed or used your product.
No, we usually say, is there market for that product? We usually ask a question, isn't it? Is there
What do you question?
No, is there market for the product? We ask usually. So market here, is there any demand for the product?
Yeah, see, generally we categorize market not with physical aspects. We say, like, you know, those who have already consumed, in marketing terminology, those who have consumed, they become the actual customers. Those who are going to consume or use become the potential customers. The culmination of these two is called market. From marketing point of view.
Got it.
It is no more commerce terminology or any other, okay, economic term. But from marketing point of view, the actual and potential customers of a product is market. And when it comes to marketing, just now I told in a philosophies, it is find a need, fill it with satisfaction, in a simple term. Otherwise, we can as well say that if you talk about Kotler's definition, social and managerial process by which individuals and groups obtain what they need and want and value with others. Matlab, social, society, right? And managerial, organization. Social and managerial process. See, it is not one time. That's the reason we use the word process. Marketing is a social and a managerial process. That means what we wanted, we are going to identify from the society. We are going to produce a product in the organization. Social and managerial process by which individuals and groups obtain what they need and want and value with others. See, there is a social strata, right? We have three levels are there. Can anybody tell me what is our social strata? BOP, bottom of pyramid, lower, middle, and higher. Right? This is what we talk in terms of social strata, right? So the lower income group guy who is at the bottom of the pyramid will always try to compare with the middle income group guy. The middle income group guy always try to compare with the elite group or a higher income. So this is what we value with others. Creating. So what we do is, it's a social and managerial process by which individuals and groups obtain what they need and want through creating and exchanging and value with others. This is how the marketing concept holds. Society is involved, organizations are involved, customer needs and wants are involved, and we try to create the creation of products are involved. We exchange the products and at the same time we value with others. When I hold a Apple iPhone with some model, then again I look at somebody's hand, he is having some additional version, latest version. So whatever we hold, we try to see that I wanted to meet that particular guys. I wanted to match him. So we continuously work on, if one want or need is satisfied, we go to the next level. This is what we normally look as we, as there is a saying, as long as we exist, human wants are unlimited. If one need or want is satisfied, the others crops up. This is how the marketing principle holds. So needs and wants are unlimited. As long as the needs and wants are unlimited, the market exists. As long as the market exists, the products and services exist. All these exist because customer needs and wants are evolving. Is it not? So it is a cyclical process. It's a cyclical process. Customer, as long as he exists, is as simple as that. Market exists, products or services exist, and finally our needs and wants. This is how we try to go ahead with our concept of marketing. Am I right? Okay. So now we need to plan. It is not when we talk about process, we need to plan a lot about this particular process. We need to plan a lot. So what do you mean by planning from general perspective? Let me not talk in a marketing point of view. What do you mean by planning in two words? In two words, what do you mean by... can you change the slide to the next?
Yes, madam. Just give me 1 minute.
Yeah. Just that slide. Okay, leave about that slide. Let it be that slide only. That's all. Not beyond.
And so we have 10 minutes more.
What do you mean by planning?
Planning is a blueprint kind of a thing.
Only one word. One or two words.
It's a blueprint. Organize.
It's a blueprint of actual, right?
Yes.
Or approach.
It's a structure.
It is a?
Hello?
I'm getting you. Next, one more idea. Any more ideas you can come out with? You know, it's not just with one word, you know. We are at the end of the day, we are talking in terms of management. So, you can explain from any point of it and it is valid. So, tell me what is planning before we entering into marketing plan. As you said, somebody said blueprint of a reality, right? Is it not? So, future course of action, somebody will tell me. So, here we say in a simplified way is forward looking. Aage ki soch, right? And I would connect this with controlling, right? See, two sides of a scissor. Marketing and controlling are two sides of a scissor. If planning and controlling are correct, then we get a straight cut. If either planning is not appropriate or controlling is not appropriate, we get a zigzag cut. Am I correct? So, because we are talking in terms of marketing plan, so we need to think about so many factors, right, from customers to leke customer service. As today, customer has become a spouse. He is no more, he or she is no more a king or a queen. Because when with the old concept of customer were considered as we need customer, you know, if you go to a shop, what it will be written? Customer. Is it not? But because today customer is considered as a spouse. Spouse. If you are not going to delight the customer, they are going to divorce. As simple as it. If customer is not delighted, they are going to divert. That means they will immediately shift to the competitor. Shift immediately to your competitor rather than sticking, right? So no more praisings of a seller. Today, customer is a spouse. If you are not delighting, they will divorce. That is a concept which is holding. So in order to fulfill that particular on a continuous and consistent basis, we need to make a planning. with the changing needs of changing customers. So what we have to do is, in a systematic way, we have to have a forward thinking. That means when it comes to forward thinking, we need to look at ourselves, that is within the organization, and we need to look at the external environment. So environmental scanning has to be done so perfectly that we, you know, when I talk about environmental perspective within the organization and external aspects, when I talk about external aspects, now let us touch marketing mix elements. What do you mean by marketing mix? Can you anybody tell me? Marketing mix. Am I getting you, participants?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. What do you mean by marketing mix?
Hello.
Can anybody tell me what do you mean by marketing mix?
Hello.
Don't say four P's.
Yeah.
Outrightly, price, don't tell
place,
me.
Four promotions.
Hey, otherwise, directly, don't tell me four P's. I said. Kuch aur bol sakte prior to that? Just now I was talking in terms of environment. Can you connect place. It to environment?
On different color.
Maybe place.
Yeah. Price, place, promotion, these are such as we call it as. But what actually you mean by marketing mix? Such as you said, 7 P's for services and 4 P's for business
products. We have used Gillette, ma'am.
Huh? Come again? We all have studied, you know, when we talk about marketing mix, because we have limited time.
Hello?
Yeah, tell me.
The tools, marketing tools that can use it, I mean, to pursue its marketing objective or...
Your voice is not clear. Yeah, now it is clear. Can you just tell me once again, what do you mean by marketing mix?
It can be the set of marketing tools that can be used for pursuing its marketing objectives or in the target market.
Yeah, absolutely right. But ek aur baat bolna hai mujhe yahan pe. When we talk about environment, we have external environment and internal environment, right? Of internal environment, internal factors and external factors are, I'll come back to you that. So when we talk about, you said set of tools. Ek aur baat, the most important element which is missing is set of controllable tools.
Okay.
Controllable tools, because that, why I said set of controllable tools is, here when we talk about controllable tool, it becomes within the organization. For example, such as like set of controllable tools such as product, price, place, promotion, and if it is services, people, process, physical evidence, am I right? Then when I talk about product, I said, I use the word controllable elements, controllable tools. I can add the features, I can reduce the features. Is it not within my control? It is within the control of an organization, right?
Yeah, Vinodini ma'am. Sorry to interrupt, we still have only 3 minutes. Would you like to continue after 3 minutes again? We need to take a 5 minute break and then continue because it's not going to continue.
If participants are interested, otherwise I don't mind. If participants are interested, I'll continue. Otherwise,
then
I don't mind.
Just check with them. Participants, if you are all okay, we can, because it's only 40 minutes what we can use on Zoom. What I will do is we'll take a small break for 5 to 8 minutes, and then again we can reconnect after 5 to 8 minutes, because the session can continue for another 40 minutes because Zoom will not allow for more than 40 minutes. It's a basic plan we have.
I will not take much 40 minutes. I'll take more 20 minutes.
Yes, so we can take a small break here. In the meantime, I request all the participants to share their email ID and full names to my WhatsApp, those who are ready to send.
That's the best option.
Already 6 people have sent it. So we'll disconnect now and we'll reconnect in another 5 to 8 minutes, because the entire session is getting recorded. It's need to get saved. It takes 5 to 6 minutes. So exactly by, it's 5:38 now, 5:45 we are reconnecting. Will that be fine with everyone? Again, 5:45 onwards, 20-minute session.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Right. Thank you so much.
You are getting me.
So, kindly connect back on the same link by 5:45. In the meantime, you can make a note of all your queries as a parking lot. You can discuss with Vinodini ma'am. So, see you guys back at 5:45 sharp on the same session.
Okay.
Kindly stay connected after 5 minutes. I mean, thank you.
Possible education.
Ma'am?
no forcible content receiving.
Yes, yes. So I'm disconnecting the meeting now. I'm ending the meeting. We'll stay. Can I get back by 5:45 sharp?